Good morning to you, Lydia. Thank you for joining me for Give Me Five this sunny morning from the West Midlands. Now, Lydia, we hear a lot about super fruits, superfoods like blackberries and blueberries. Tell me, what do you think about that?
Well, I have to say blackberries and blueberries. It's good that you mentioned both of them because they are wonderful foods. They're called foods with antioxidants in them. And antioxidants are really good for fighting like things like pollutants and things that are in the air that we absorb, like car fumes and things. So if we eat blackberries and blueberries, it actually helps flush those things out. So yeah, and actually the great thing is blackberries grow naturally, so we can actually pick them ourselves. So that's a good thing.
They do, because Paul and I have been picking blackberries and really enjoying the fruits of those. And in Genesis chapter 1, God sort of gives us some tips about nature's food, because he talks about the fruits and the berries and things like that. So you agree with that?
Totally. I believe that God gave us everything that we need. And I only made that discovery because I got diagnosed in 2015 with multiple sclerosis. And I discovered that a lot of what we need to fight illness has already been provided to us, but it's just a case of finding those foods that kind of help. I'll go more into detail later, but yeah, it's those foods are wonderful, and I do believe that God has provided us with those foods to help fight the nasties that come on us.
So yeah, I'm sure you're right there, Lydia. Do you think then God is bothered about us eating things like crisps and cheesy wopsits all the time?
Absolutely. You know, in the big media market, we are constantly being told, oh, eat these new cheesy wopsits or anything like that, and that when we eat them, it can have a terrible effect on our health. So you know, if we can kind of tune into more the foods that are better for us,
yes,
I do believe like God is guiding us to go back to those foods that keep our health, as I believe God wants us to be healthy to be. So yeah, so that's in a nutshell.
Yeah, that's a really good answer. And how has these good foods helped you? I mean, has it helped you with stress in your life as well as your health? Tell us a bit more.
Like I said earlier, antioxidants, amazing. So I eat every morning, I actually create a smoothie with berries in, which is absolutely wonderful. So that clears out any stuff that I've been absorbing from the atmosphere. It helps to start my day. And also kale. Kale is another one, it's a superfood.
Yeah.
And place that in my smoothie as well, because kale is absolutely wonderful. Vitamin C, which we all know helps fighting virus and things, and also vitamin K, which is really good for us, and it's an antioxidant. But also kale helps with digestion as right. well. And if we can sort out our digestion, then we get rid of the stuff that we put in our body through going to the toilet naturally, because a lot of people suffer from like things like constipation and
yes.
things like that. So you know, if you can have kale, that actually helps with digestion. So yeah, so I swear by that every morning. That really helps. Just and a cup of clear water, lovely. I just down it and it just helps with digestion as well. So
well, you look very healthy, so you're a good advert for this. I remember a friend of mine made me a smoothie and it had some kale in it,
yeah,
and cucumber and stuff, and yeah. it looked really green, and I thought, I don't know about this, but it tasted delicious. So yeah. anybody out there listening today, I would recommend what you're saying for sure.
Can I just add as well, Jeannie, the kale, yes. I would also say if you can grow your own, because then you're not putting nasties like pesticides. Yeah. I'm a big believer in when pesticides get sprayed on food grown, it can actually affect the system as well. So if you can learn to grow your own kale in your back garden, you only need like a tiny little garden, or even sometimes in a window, yeah. it's amazing. And now Lidl and places like that are actually selling kale.
Brilliant.
So they're organic brilliant. Kale.
And yeah. organic stuff is so much better for you anyway,
yeah.
isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, and if you can grow your own, that's even better. So has it helped you with stress at all in your life, these foods? Because they're good for us.
I think stress is very much in the mind, and knowing that I'm giving my body good stuff has helped, but there are also foods that help with stress, like Brazil nuts, which actually release selenium, and which is really good for lowering your stress levels. Turmeric, which helps with inflammation in the body. If you put turmeric when you cook, when you season food, turmeric is really good. And also, I've got to think now, I've got to rack my brain.
These are good tips.
Chamomile tea. I make sure I have a chamomile tea every night, because that's like a calmer, and it just gets you get nice relaxed kind of state. Yeah, so chamomile tea I swear by as well.
Sounds good to me. Now, you're currently writing a book. Can you tell us a little bit more about this?
Okay, so it's called MS Survival, Hopeless to Hopeful. And it's basically about my journey, just when MS was thrown at me. Hey, you've got MS. And I had a load of drugs at the time thrown at me as well, yes, as a diagnosis. And I didn't have a peace over that. So I prayed, you know, because I have a big faith that's carried me every
yes,
step of the way.
I can very see faithful, that, yes. God.
And yeah, so I was led to go down the natural foods. And I found that there were certain foods that were irritating the MS, and there were certain foods that actually was helping it. So things like dairy and gluten actually aggravate certain things in your brain. So I had to eliminate those, yes, and then put in the good clean foods that we were just talking about that were helping build the remyelination, it's called, of our brains. And right, it just, yeah, it helped me like every step of the way. So I'm writing about that. But I'm also writing about my undercurrent, because we can learn about all these fantastic foods.
Yes.
But I think we need something undercurrent with that. And for me, it was my walk with God. So that's part of my book as well.
Brilliant. So it's watch this space with your book when it gets published, and we will look out for it. What's the title again, Lydia, please?
MS Survival, Hopeless to Hopeful.
Brilliant. And we'll look forward to reading that when it comes out. You've given us some really good top tips this morning, and I think a lot of us will take those things on board. So that's a really good thing. So Lydia, thank you so much. You've been absolutely fantastic to interview this morning, and a mind of information to help all of us. So thank you so much, and a good day to you. Thank you, Lydia. God bless you. Have a good day. Bye for now.